In searching for the military hardware in the Gulf War, the satellite showed up something interesting in Egypt. It showed a great desert road written of in Exodus, a discovery that shocked even hardened skeptics. Critics had said for years that the events of Exodus had never happened and were not real. Now, the red line seen by the spy satellite came down to the sea of the Gulf of Aqaba and then continued into what is present-day Saudi Arabia, that traced the route as if it were drawn by God's own hand, and traced the exact route of the Hebrew Exodus. And the sea area between these two red lines is precisely where the dive teams discovered the Egyptian chariots, the wheels, and the skeletal remains. With regards to the Gulf War, Saddam Hussein had roughly 1,500 heavy tanks positioned on the border between Iraq and Saudi Arabia. And in order to conceal them, he buried them in sand, leaving only the gun turrets sticking out. These were well camouflaged and effectively made them invisible from the air or from ground surveillance use. But they were discovered. America shifted its spy satellite into position over the Iraqi desert, and the American spy satellite, which was equipped with infrared scanners, took pictures of the cold desert floor during the twilight hours from 155 miles above the Earth. This satellite with its infrared detectors could detect a temperature difference of only a degree or so. Now, the satellite was placed in position to take pictures of the buried tanks because the tanks would heat up during the daylight hours, and because they were mostly metal, they would hold on to the heat long after the sun had gone down and the rest of the desert began to cool during the night. To the spy satellite, the buried tanks showed up as bright shapes in the dark. So the exact location of each tank was then plotted, targeted on a map, and then given to Allied jets. Quite by accident, the satellite also discovered other things that astonished the military. The satellite found evidence to support the story of Moses, who led the exodus of the Hebrews from Egypt, and the drowning of Pharaoh's pursuing army of charioteers across the Red Sea. When the Gulf War finally ended, archaeologists went back to the region to discover how it was possible for a 3,500-year-old trail to exist well enough to show up on a satellite photo. They found that a large, vast number of people, no doubt with much livestock, pulverized and disrupted the sand. Then, during the desert nights, the humidity rose, thus wetting the powdery sand, making it hardened like unto a concrete-like substance. And through the years, the highway was buried by shifting sands, thus protecting the trail from the elements. However, during the day, just below the surface, it would heat up, much like the Iraqi tanks, being that it was more dense than the surrounding sand, and continue holding the heat longer into the cold nights, thus showing up brightly for the satellite.